You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
Okay, now that we're back in Silhouette, we need to add a PowerMesh Warp node. And then we're going to hook up the data ports so that the PowerMesh Warp node can use the data from the Mocha Pro node. So we'll go to this tab here, the PowerMesh Warp, and we'll select our mesh. And we'll select Unwarp so we can look at it in a more stabilized view and normal. But if I just scrub through, you can just see that we see this arm area in the stabilized view. And now we're going to paint a frame, and then we're going to apply the track from the mesh to our painted frame with auto paint. So I want to select a frame that's not too distorted and no big lighting change. Something in the middle, I think. So 60 looks good. But first I need to add a paint node. Let's bring in a paint node here. And we'll hook that up. And now we can start painting. And sometimes what I do, if I wasn't sure of an area, I'll just do a quick test stroke. So for example, I can go to the color brush here, select a color, and I'll just make like a straight line to see how the stabilization is going. Just click down Alt and click, and now I have a straight line there. And I just want to apply this track to I want to apply the paint to the track, I can just play here. I don't need to select match move because we are already attached to a stabilized frame. And if I play that across and I just do that, I think it's going to work out pretty good. So then I'll just undo that, I'll just delete that, trash can, rebuild, yes. And then we'll start from fresh. Okay, so one thing I'm going to do is actually I'm going to change this precision to best. Okay, now we can start painting. So I'm going to zoom in here and I'm just going to start with the clone tool. Press C. I'm going to paint to the alpha. Make my softness 100%. And I'm just going to start from the outside and work my way in. And it's going to be a little bit rough at first. I'm also making an effort to pull in from areas that are somewhat nearby as to preserve some of the frame-by-frame color changes. If I pulled in from up top to paint down on the lower arm, that might introduce some flickering. And you might ask, why don't I just use a clean plate? And it's because there are subtle lighting changes in the shot as well as variable light changes on the upper and lower part of the arm. It's not a global fix. Auto paint will pick up the subtle changes as it is pulling from each frame in time to paint each frame. And you might notice that I'm using output as my source in the clone tab. This is using my already painted areas to keep using as my source. And you can set that as a preference. And I'm not just painting just the areas that need to be painted. I'm just painting a little bit more around them. Because if there is stretching or warping that is more than just the frame that I'm painting right here, I won't have enough paint for the coverage. And then I'm also going outside the edge on the right just to get a little more coverage in case the warping is pulling some of that paint back in. So I'm just using the clone tool at various opacities here. And then if I see it's getting a little soft in the middle, so now I'm going to use the detail brush to bring in some of that detail. So I'm going to just select the detail button here, and I'm going to keep it at 1, which is for fine details. And I'm going to just paint in the color view, or I should say the normal view. So I'm just going to select, use a big brush, and I'm just going to clone with the 50% down to this soft area to bring in maybe some more of the hair or the skin texture. So when I'm painting in the detail mode in the paint tab, I'm painting in detail, but I'm preserving the color, so I'm just changing one of the layers. And I can even use the dodge tool. So click on the dodge tool here. I'm probably going to use a pretty low opacity, 30. And I'm going to still be in the detail mode here. Make my brush a little smaller. So I'm just adding some more highlighted areas here. And that's just giving it some more definition. Sometimes you can go really small, and it's a low opacity. You don't really want any lines, but you can just kind of add little paint strokes just to give it a little more texture. And even with the burn tool. Okay, so then I have a bunch of paint strokes here I can apply with the auto paint.